denominator, you must look at the numerator. What do you plug in first for x? A plus f of b's, this is my t value. Okay, 2 plus a plus 8 over 5 minus a plus 8. Or when you distribute this subtraction sign through, you get 5 minus a minus. Minus. Now what do I plug? A, 2 plus over. Write the h over 1 because again we have a complex fraction. It looks disgusting, but it actually works out very, very nicely. It's at this next point that many people start to give up factor sense. You have to push through this point. You can't give up. It looks more difficult, but the process is the same. It's a complex fraction, so what do I have to do at the top? My common denominators. What's the common denominator going to be? 5 minus h times 5 minus a minus h. So multiply top and bottom here by 5 minus a minus h. And this is where people like, well, no math problem would ever require this small words that I want to do. No. Doing it. That you're using to simplify the memory are the skills that you learned back in 9th grade algebra. Multiple, that's not that big of a deal, is it? Just the question is, are you willing to push through and have the patience to see the problem from the beginning to end? So, let's see how this looks out. Tell me, I'm going to multiply this through, what do I get? Just multiply polynomials. That doesn't have an h. It doesn't have an h. It has to cancel the thought problem. So, let's take cancel. dividing by calculus all centers down. Let's do that. Hey, I got an idea. Multiply by the somebody tell me why did I multiply by what's the value of this expression right now? 1, so I can change the value of the value. However, what makes this the conjugate? What part of the plus the value of that? That's it. Now, it works out very, very nicely. What is the square root of a plus a plus 4 times the square root of a plus a plus 4? A plus A plus 4. Do you have to worry about the middle? No. Minus. What is the square root of A plus 4 times the square root of A plus 4? Already, quantity of A plus 4. All over. H times quantity of square root of k plus 8 plus 4 plus the square root of k plus 4. Look at the numerator. What do you notice? The 8s canceled. The 4s, because this is a positive 4, this is a negative 4 due to the subtraction sign. What are you left with in the numerator? Is there an h in the denominator that's factored out? Therefore, if you cancel it, what are you left with in the numerator? 1. Therefore, the result is 1 over the square root of k plus k plus 4 plus the square root of k plus 4. That is an expression for the f of 2, which eventually calculus will be able to use to get the instantaneous rate of change. I like that math. All
right, yeah, she says it's fun. All right, yeah, I'll buy it.
There you go.
See, Jack would never do that, Colton would never do that, Dominic would never do that, Matt would never do that, you would never do that, you would never do that, only you would do that.
What? I'm so proud of you guys. Every single class is that set. Can you have a square at the bottom? If it's not a number, you can. So if there's a variable under a square root, you're okay. But it's paired with a variable. Anything that, if it's just like square root of 5, then no, that's the rule. Yes. You can have more degrees. Last example. We want to show the average rate of change is the slope using a plus h, that's the interval, and our function is negative 2x plus 5. Can somebody tell me what is the average rate of change of that function for the interval 4 to 9? Try again. The average rate of change is the same as what? The slope. What is the average rate of change of that function? Is the slope for a line always the same, or does it change? Always the same. Always the same. How about for parabola? Is it the same, or does it change? It changes. It curves around. The slope for a line is always the same. So it doesn't matter what coordinates we choose for x, we should come up with negative 2 for the slope. The average rate of change. Let's try it. F of b minus f of a all over b minus a. What is b minus a? H. So look at the top. No, this is to be super easy. What is f of b? Right? Minus, parentheses, what is f of a? All we want to do is simplify that. What is this simplified to right here?
All over. Again, remember, what should we get as the answer?
Negative two to the negative two.
For that line.
We could, no, but
Alex, you raise a good question. We could just change it to y equals mx plus b and prove that the average rate of change is always m. 182, 914, stand up your work, folks. I'm guessing that the test will be next week, Tuesday. Testing before this week is over. We have section 2-5 to get through yet. We'll go on next quarter. I think so, yeah.